Thank you very much, and good afternoon from me. Let me start off, probably not surprisingly. I'm incredibly happy and honored to be here with you and to be allowed to actually share that very proud moment with you. Especially, and that's been also mentioned several times today, under the truly even more challenging circumstances that you've all faced over the past years and that you've managed to master and receive your graduation here today. I think the COVID-19 pandemic has really turned all of our lives a bit on its head, and we've all had to find different coping strategies. And I'm saying that knowing that all of us here and have what I've always called won the lottery of life, meaning that we've been born in a place and at a time and in circumstances that give us more coping strategies and more opportunities than most of the other people have on this planet. So just sitting here today, you should be incredibly proud of what you've achieved due to your own achievements and really not just take it for granted. Because if you look at it at a global perspective, it isn't. Just a little thought experiment here before we get started. Imagine the same you, same person with all of your strengths and your weaknesses and all of your ambitions are born somewhere else. Maybe in a little village in South Sudan or a war-torn city. Would you be sitting here today? It's very, very unlikely, because the abilities and the opportunities are so very different here in this world. It still matters so much where on our beautiful planet you're born today. And why am I talking about that? Because what you've achieved today is one of the most important foundations for the rest of your life. In fact, there's so much research showing that the more education you achieve, the better off you likely be in your life. Better educated women, particularly in poorer countries, they will marry later, they will have fewer children, they will have healthier children, a higher nutritional status. It can actually help them lift families out of poverty, but even more, whole communities and whole countries. Or something that might be much closer related to you, more education usually means a higher salary, higher wages in your future life as well. So that's why it's so important. How many graduates are there here today? I think a little bit less than 100, but I'm not so good at guessing like this, I suppose. But let's go for 100, because it's probably easier than to do the next sort of thought experiments here. Let's imagine all of you represent 100 average people of this world. So you're representing the world population. How many of you would have gone to primary school? If it was today, a bit over 80%. Would have been able to go every now and again at least, attend school every now and again, if you're lucky, even see a teacher. Less than half of you would be able to read or write by the time you turn 10. Less than a third of you would have been able to have secondary education. I'm not even talking about tertiary education. And now if you think that that is the average, and obviously it's not very equally distributed in this world, many countries, most of the ones that we come from are lucky, and we have 100% of the kids in primary school and other education. A lot of other countries aren't. If you were a girl born in Niger, you would probably have about 15% of a chance to ever attend primary school. But why am I saying this? Not to make you feel bad, not at all, but just to maybe open your eyes a little bit of how privileged we all are. And actually, there's been so much improvement over the past decades in all of this. If you look at the last two decades, the number of children that are out of school has actually reduced by 40%. And that has been a lot of the time due to people like you, people who've had more opportunities and then have actually dedicated their life to improve those of others. And that must not mean you directly work in development like me, but it means that people have dedicated maybe parts of their life, maybe their jobs to working in government, or maybe some of their wealth for also improving the lives of others that have not won the lottery of birth. So what are my messages here for you today? Well, the first one I already started off with, and a lot of people have been saying that, is celebrate, cherish the moment. I know you'd probably all love to celebrate even more grandly today, and the circumstances won't allow, but I think, you know, it's already feels very exciting that we're all here today, and it's a very important step. Those moments in life are short, and I'm really glad to be here with today. Second, and that has been partially mentioned also already, be thankful. And I'm not talking about having won the lottery of life, but I'm talking about also to those people who have supported you to reach where you are today. family, friends, whether it is emotionally or financially, we're always stronger together, and it's very rare that we manage things completely alone. And it's actually those people in life that create such an important foundation. It's those that bring us through tougher times and that we can also share joyous moments like today with, and it's so precious. So be thankful. Thirdly, believe in yourselves. Maybe some of you have been lucky and you've not had any setbacks in life. I definitely have had a lot of setbacks in life. They're not fun, but you learn a lot from them. But it's important not to give up. I'm guessing a lot of you are starting to apply for jobs. Maybe some of you are already in the job market. It's really sort of going that next step in life. And I'm guessing a lot of you will need quite a high tolerance for frustration. Many of you will send probably what feels like, and maybe even is, hundreds of applications before you finally get your foot in the door somewhere. That's normal. Believe in yourself. It'll work out at some point. See it as a way also to reflect on whether you're trying to go in the right direction. See it as a way to test your endurance and your resilience, because those are really important skills no matter what you do in life. And understand that every sorry but no answer you get might actually have a deeper meaning. Sometimes you need to go through a few detours before you end up where you wanted to go. And this is something for everyone, but particularly the women under you, among you. Don't undersell yourselves. I've been on the hiring end for quite a few years now, and I've quite consistently seen particularly women underselling themselves. Don't. You don't need to. You can be proud for what you've achieved. You've done amazing things. Go and sell yourself for what you're worth, really. And maybe just a short discourse from my own life. Some of it was already presented, but it might show you what I meant by doing a little bit of a detour. So my father's from Argentina, and I was lucky enough to go and visit that beautiful country as a child frequently. And I have a very vivid memory of, I think, the first time I went. I must have been about 6 or 7. I was sitting in a restaurant outdoors, eating my lunch and leaving more than half left over, as we also often do in our cultures. And a couple of kids came along, complete strangers. They didn't look very well off. They might even have been homeless. And they asked whether they could eat my leftovers. That was such an eye-opening moment for me that from that very moment I knew, wow, okay, not everyone's as lucky as me. Let me go and try and do something about it, whatever is within my abilities. So I set my mind to that. And I actually first started off studying chemistry. Not a lot of people know that. I did a whole year of chemistry. I wanted to go into virology, do research in Ebola and malaria in developing countries, but I figured out maybe not my thing, so I switched and did social and cultural anthropology and a lot of development work. And while I was doing that, I was doing lots of internships as well to understand what do I actually enjoy doing. And I did internships with the UN, I did internships at NGOs, at government agencies, and so on. And to be very honest, I was very disillusioned most of the time. And it was really quite frustrating some of the time. So I ended up, as was mentioned before, as a strategy consultant with the Boston Consulting Group. And it was one of the best jobs I've ever had, even though it wasn't planned for at all. And it was one of the jobs I learned the most, and I have the strongest network. And that was mentioned before, how important networks are. The strongest network until today. Until I saw my dream job advertised at the Austrian Development Agency that was newly founded. I read the job specification, but I didn't apply. I didn't dare to apply because I did not fulfill all of the criteria. So I continued my other job until I saw it re-advertised, thinking, maybe they're having issues finding the right person. So I applied, I got invited to the interview, but I wasn't successful, I was second. The first candidate, a successful candidate, declined the job, actually ended up going to a job that I had left a few months ago because I didn't like it by coincidence, and I got the job offer, and that's how I started my career. Why am I telling you all of this and giving you a little bit of an insight is because sometimes, you know, life takes you through detours and its special ways. But in the end, if you know what you want, you'll end up where you want to be. And that is my second last message to you. Know yourself. Know what you enjoy, because that's usually what you're good at. Know what you like doing. As an adult, you'll spend most of your life at work, whether in years or whether in hours of the day. You'll spend more lifetime at work than you will with your family and other things, at least most of us that work full time. So you better find something you actually enjoy doing. Of course, we need external recognition as well, and you want to earn a decent salary that helps you live your life. But try and find a balance there. So rather than maybe just thinking categories, that's something that's really helped me when you go on and about your job search and where you want to end up, think about what you enjoy doing, what you're good at, look at your values, and look for something that matches both. It actually opens the opportunities and the perspective a lot wider. And last but not least, I'm not expecting everyone to share my human compassion, but I do ask of you to at least practice what I call enlightened self-interest. What does that mean? We live in a global system. Everything we do has an impact on others. And I think the COVID pandemic at the moment demonstrates that very clearly. We will not find solutions if we don't think globally, if we don't think about how does our action here actually impact on others and how can we support others that maybe don't have the means to do the same, because again, that will impact us as well. Climate change is another wonderful example like that. So whatever you end up doing, think about at least not doing any harm. And circling back to the very beginning, remember how privileged you are, and I really mean it, the world is yours. You have to understand that. The world is yours, and you can actually go and be the change that you want to see in this world. So good luck with that. Thank you.